Yeah. Hello. Welcome to another edition of Bits and Banter. This morning, we are going to discuss last night's entertainer, Rajasthan Royals versus Delhi Capitals. Batting first, Delhi Capitals kind of scored a middling 147 for 8 without actually being in control of their batting scores. In reply, Rajasthan Royals huffed and puffed their way through bulk of their innings. I'm practically out of the match by around 15th over, but by end, they managed to score 150 for 7 and they won with two balls to spare. It's one of those strange matches which didn't exactly fit into any kind of pattern. Raj, your thoughts on that? Good morning.
Yeah, I mean, for me, the most important point was that refusal of taking a single by Sanju Samson. It happened in another match. Then you see how things are connected in the world. So
exactly.
So day. Yeah, ring எடுக்க மாட்டியா? I'll show you now. Like that.
Suddenly, Sanju Samson looks a fool from the previous match.
I know.
Not because of anything from this match.
Yeah.
I mean, that's ridiculous.
I still believe
that's what Sanju Samson did in the first match.
I agree.
Perfectly okay.
I'm kidding. I agree. I think Sanju Samson did exactly what I think. I mean, I think the best thumbs up that Sanju Samson could have got actually came from Chris Morris in the post-match yesterday, exactly. Where he said, look, I mean, 100 times I would have actually got Sanju Samson to sort of, I would have run and sacrificed my wicket, but I would have got Sanju Samson to sort of go for it because he's batting 119 here. He has a better chance of hitting a six than somebody who just come in. So I was just kidding.
He put it well. Raj, yeah. What do you think the match was won and lost last night?
I think the match was won. Before we go there, I mean, I would say, it was a weird match. Like you said, Bala, you hit the nail on the head. It was a weird match. You had bad batting, bad bowling, good bowling, alternating. So it was almost exactly. Like, okay, who wants to do it better or who wants to do it worse? So it was a bit like that. So for example, look at the way Sanju Samson got out this time. I mean, it was a sucker ball and he got sucked into it after scoring a century. Exactly. Forgot that that was another match. This is not continuing that match. And then Rishabh Pant, who actually batted reasonably well and he was going very well, is daft enough to get run out where there was probably no run. It was a brilliant piece of fielding, no doubt, did that. Then
he
you had a
took it easy.
Yeah, he it took it easy. Yeah. Then we had a situation where Delhi was going very well with the bowling. Till they decided that Ashwin is not going to bowl his fourth over, despite
yes,
going for 14
runs. Yes, I wanted
runs.
To pick you on your brain on
we'll
that.
We'll get there. We'll get there.
Yeah.
That is, let me complete this. He bowled three overs for 14 runs. He doesn't get a fourth. Who gets the over instead? Marcus Stoinis, who goes for 15 runs in one
15
over.
15 runs. Yeah.
That's so that was it.
These are kind of captaincy notes,
yes.
Raj.
Yeah.
Especially with somebody like Ricky Ponting sitting in the dugout. I don't think whether the message really got out to the captain or the captain made a mistake or what really happened there?
See, the entire thing was like that. So, which is why I said that entire match was just going back and forth to a point where it was it became very difficult. I think the punters, the betting guys, they would have not keep punting. Betting guys, they would have had a field day yesterday because, I mean, the match was oscillating more than a pendulum, man. So, so seriously, it was like a pendulum in fast motion, not slow motion, like the way it moves.
Yeah, but as we are saying, it's a bizarre match, but even within this bizarre match, there were portions which was interesting because we'll talk of from the start, Delhi batting. Mm. Delhi batting, they lost pretty much the top hop within the first 6-7 overs. 4 wickets were bad. But
yeah.
I thought Rishabh Pant played well, his first 50 as a captain. He was motoring along till he, as you said, he kind of lost it. I mean, he was slightly ambling. Because there was no intention. I mean, he took it rather casually. That was there. But I thought the way Rajasthan Royals bowlers bowled, that was pretty good because they really took the pace of the ball. And that was one of those talking points of this match because them taking the pace of the ball while Delhi bowlers went for the exact opposite. So
that
was
the
kind of
So that was also again weird because see, Unadkat at the post-match, he said he hardly bowled 4 or 5 balls which were slower. So, I mean, his speed was a slower ball, I think. That was his maximum speed.
No, he said that he bowled slower. I mean, they didn't give any
spaces. No,
that's
he said.
What he said.
Right? He said, no, okay. He said he was bowling the normal speed. He bowled 4 or 5 slower balls. So, to us, it appeared that he was bowling slower balls. Again, see, every time the Delhi fast bowlers were bowling good lengths and good speeds, they were getting wickets. Every okay. time they were see, it was a weird pitch. That's what I'm saying. It was. So I, in fact, in between, I tweeted saying that.
No, because I, like what Chennai. I wrote was, Ulatkar, what he said was, he didn't want to give the batters any extra bit of pace. Extra bit of pace was.
I don't think he has extra bit of pace anymore.
That's what I was thinking.
No, he said that. I can quote him there. I mean, I was reading this right just before we started. If you see the stats, I think he only bowled about 4 or 5 change of pace. That's what he said.
Change of pace because they didn't bowl any pace ball because we didn't want to give any extra bit of pace because I remember hearing that.
No, he didn't say that. I was hitting hard lengths and hitting good lengths. Okay, that was what he said. So, Mustafizur was bowling a lot of, I don't know. I mean, I think commentators were also pointing out that he was, I mean, it was like a Muralidharan action from left arm. So he was bowling pretty differently. They had 3 bowlers bowling the same side of the wicket, right? And each of them got different.
So it's one of those strange matches where you had 3 left-arm pace bowlers.
Yes.
Starting for Rajasthan Royals. Because I think...
But you are right. I'll agree that Rajasthan Royals probably bowled better. And Delhi batsmen batted badly. Because if you look at it, there were 2 wickets, if I remember distinctly. One was Stoinis and I think another one, I don't remember, who actually got beaten by the... lack of pace off the wicket.
They were suckered into playing fall shots, and that yes. came about because of their lack of pace.
Exactly. Yeah. But otherwise, all of them got out pretty much why would Shikhar Dhawan play the shot that he played? You have no idea. But then Sanju Samson brought out a brilliant catch. Exactly. Reminded me of Rahul Dravid and Brendan McCullum. I remember that.
WhatsApp group.
So Dravid was surprised. He was not supposed to be there. He was supposed to be here. How did he get there?
There were a lot of parallels. One of those mini parallels within this 2 innings was the Rishabh Pant kind of emulated Samson by grabbing the second wicket with again a terrific catch.
The
Rajasthan Royals were batting.
Yeah, but then Pant's was that it was going to his right side. It was going to his right side, but then on the other side.
Other side. Yeah, exactly.
But then anyway, that was a great parallel.
But I wanted to ask you one thing, Raj. Because Chris Morris, of course, he was the man of the occasion for Rajasthan Royals. I mean, he kind of justified his price tag with big sixes. But there was kind of a vote of confidence against him when Rajasthan Royals was bowling. Because he had one over to finish, but they didn't go for him in the last over. They went for the younger Chetan Chakaria. Because that was a vote of confidence against him. What do you think, Raj?
See, that's what I'm saying. No, I think both teams looked at the wicket differently. I think that RR actually looked at the wicket where you take the pace off and you don't get slogged. And which is why they took him off. Whereas the other guys, whenever they were bowling fast, the Delhi bowlers, they actually, most of the wickets they picked was because of good pace and good line and length.
Exactly.
So that is where I think both of them read the pitch differently. I think
with the kind of wickets they had, they also read it in a sense correctly also.
Correctly,
for their bowlers.
Yeah. See, I mean, you asked me right in the beginning, where did the Delhi lose the match? I think they lost the match by just sort of letting things amble for a bit. The match game ambled for a bit. When you are 50 plus or 50 for 5 or 6 or whatever the score was. So, I mean, you need to go for the kill. I don't think Rishabh Pant did that. I think that is where the challenge was. See, Ashwin had one over. He didn't complete. And then they went for Tom Curran. They went for everybody. It was almost like, oh, you know what? We'll take it deep. Arey Baba, you only have this many runs. Why do you want to take it deep? It was almost like you are following somebody else's template, in my mind.
Exactly. But I'm certainly with you because Delhi kind of took it easy because they took it for granted that they were there was a certain air of complacency. But having said that, the innings that David Miller played, that was also pretty crucial. That kind of set it up for Chris Morris. If David Miller hadn't played, because those 2 sixes, the first 6 of those match came around 16, 17 to over. That was pretty interesting, but that innings was pretty crucial. That kind of gave the momentum which was never there in the Rajasthan Royals innings.
Correct. Mm-hmm. So see, this is the thing. This is where the point was that Delhi, I don't think after Pant got out, I mean, actually, besides Pant, nobody actually played any sort of hand, barring a few hits by Tom Curran and Chris Wokes. But that was too little too late. I think Pant mentioned they were 20 short.
See, at Vankade, if you're going to end your innings without a single 6, that in itself tells a tale.
Exactly. So see, that is where the, I think that is where the change is. See, my question to you is, look, Delhi, I mean, what went wrong with their batting, Bala? That is, see, because they pride themselves in their batting. What were they trying to do?
See, there was no clear plan, but I also had a problem with their selection itself, because to drop Shimran Hetmyer, because he has not had a consistent run. I mean, though as a batsman, he's inconsistent, but they are compounding it with without having giving him a cup. Even, I mean, it's pretty rare to see him bat for two innings together for Delhi. That's a bit unfair on him. See, somebody like Stoinis was that. Just a couple of innings in his entire career for Delhi Capitals. Good innings, but he has had a pretty decent run with Delhi, whereas Shimran Hetmyer, even after, like, if I remember, even after he scored a pretty impressive 40-odd in one innings, he got dropped. So that's pretty unfair. I still think they need to find a place for him where he will be kind of assured of at least three or four matches. So go there, go express yourself. So that kind of a thing, I really don't know, because I mean, I get the feeling, though I may be totally wrong because I don't have any inside info. I'm just getting a feeling that Ricky Ponting is not too very confident of Hetmyer. When you don't play him so consistently, that is the kind of impression that you get, right?
So I'll add to that. See, if you look more deeply into that, you actually had two. You went for two changes. You went for Hetmyer. You to drop Hetmyer and Amit Mishra, and you took in Lalit Yadav and Tom
Curran. Lalit Yadav.
Yeah, Lalit Yadav didn't bowl. He was supposed to be an all-rounder who could bowl off-spin. I mean, why would Lalit Yadav bowl when Ashwin didn't complete his four overs? That was one point. So his bowling went out of the... Amit Mishra would have given you four overs or three overs or two overs or something. And you're not...
Which is okay. But, okay, you bolstered your batting.
No, my point is that. So you bolstered your batting by taking out a batsman. Think of it. Hetmyer is any day a better batsman than these two chaps combined. Isn't it?
Exactly.
He comes with a pedigree. So what did you do? You took away a good batsman and a good bowler and put two half there.
Exactly.
So which didn't make sense. So you're right. Which didn't make
a bit bizarre.
It was bizarre with a capital B and all the other alphabets also. For me, that didn't make any sense. See, at the end of the day, your batsmen need to bat and your bowlers need to bowl, right? They need to bowl well. See, if you look at RR, their bowlers bowled well. Okay, this fellow, I mean, Chris Morris had an off day. He bowled, but then the other four bowlers bowled well. So in this case, you had a scenario. See, I mean, I sort of felt that KG coming in was okay. But then I also felt that KG, if the ball was stopping and coming in, as we are saying, then he is easy meat, right? Which is what happened in the last but one over. But that happens. Last overs and all, you see, after you cross the 17th or 16th over, anything can happen.
Threshold. Anything can happen. Batsman just try to put bat onto the ball.
I'll give you another data, another piece of data, Bala. I mean, look at Miller came in the fourth over to bat. And he built his innings through the time. And I think that is where they missed the trick. They somehow felt that, see, maybe they didn't analyze properly. Miller is coming off peak form from South Africa.
Exactly.
I mean, he has played
brilliantly. He has had a middling season in South Africa, but he wanted to prove himself because he came in only because Ben Stokes was injured.
Correct. Not just that. I mean, I think his last innings were some 80, 40 ball 80 or something like that.
Yeah, but...
When a guy comes in, you need to nail it that there and then. So Ricky Ponting, coming from Ricky Ponting, who's been an Australian captain, Australians who have always done that. They don't let you out once they have your their foot on your neck. They don't loosen the grip. So exactly. Here I
that's
feel they loosen
because
the grip.
That's a good point because Ashwin not bowling four overs because he was bowling three overs on the trot and he was good. In contrast with it, Vunatkar, who was generally not given to bowling three overs in the power play, he was good. I mean, since he was getting those wickets and since he was in fine groove, Rajasthan Royals let him bowl and he bowled his four overs within the first half, within the first 10 overs, which is pretty good captaincy, which is because you understand the bowler is in groove, you go with the flow with it.
In 9 overs, in 9 overs from over four when Miller came into 13 when he went berserk, they just let him while his time. I think that is where they lost the match. And Delhi, I mean, see now, RR, do they have something to be happy about? It is a middling sort of a game, I would say. I don't think they have great things to be happy about. But then the fact that they won lost one close encounter and won the other, should make them feel happy that we are back in form. That is because that is what they have been doing over the last many years. There's no consistency.
Royals have reason to be worried about when you score 26 for 3 in the power play, which is lowest so far in this IPL.
Yeah,
they have reasons to worry, right?
Correct. So it is not as if, I don't think either of the teams came up trumps yesterday. So I think we'll end with the word you started with for this match, at least, bizarre was I think the right word. It was completely bizarre.
Because 12 power play overs in the two innings, they had 42 dot balls put together, which is huge. And I can understand this happening in Chennai, slow dry pitch in Chennai. This happening in Wankhede is kind of interesting and intriguing.
Yeah, so we'll wait for the next match in Wankhede and see whether there is an action replay, but which is happening today. So,
Super Kings versus Punjab Kings.
So CSK still doesn't have the services of their two fast bowlers, Ngidi and Jason Bhairandhav. So, I think same team.
Most likely. Because though the bowlers were carted all around in the first match against Delhi Capitals, I don't think it was a bad bowling performance as much as Prithvi Shah and Dhawan finding their groove. So it was one of those things. They had the batsmen in the first match had a good time. So I wouldn't be overly critical of CSK's first match performance. I would still go with the same level.
So any changes, from the batting point of view, I think they did pretty well. So the batting unit takes care of itself. Bowling-wise, do you think there is anything that they would want to do differently? Like bring in Krishnappa Gautam, I don't know. I'm just asking.
I don't know. Who will he replace in the level?
I'm just randomly asking you.
Because if you bring in Krishnappa Gautam, you would actually dislodge the batting, equilibrium of this team, which is kind of set, because I would still want Moeen Ali and Sam Curran to be in the 11. So that's my 11. Because Bravo, he among the bowlers, he was the most consistent in the first match. So Bravo, Moeen Ali and Sam Curran. And of course, you still need Faf. So four foreigners are taken care of. So if at all you need to bring in Krishnappa Gautam, it would be strange for me to say this, but you have to remove a batsman, which in this case would be Amarty Raidu.
Yeah. So we'll leave it there.
View on Punjab, do they need to do anything different?
Punjab will do anything different. I mean, unless they want to, they probably would want to tighten the give a kick up the backside of their two overseas bowlers who went for playing.
Yeah, Jai Richardson and Riley Meredith.
So
because
other than that,
Meredith had debut for Punjab that he had every reason to forget because he went for plenty.
Same with Jai Richardson also, no?
Yeah, that's
both of them went for plenty. So for me, that was, I think Punjab's, that opening bowling thing, which was, Shami had done pretty well. I think that is where they need to have a slight look. So, Jai Richardson went for...
And they also need to improve their fielding because they
Richardson went for
quite a few other.
Richardson went for 55 and Meredith went for 49. So,
they also dropped a few catches. Yeah. Murugan Ashwin dropped one. Rahul dropped one.
So which brings me to the last two matches, Bala. So I think both teams would go unchanged. Last two matches, the fielding standards have suddenly bumped up, substantially increased. If you notice, yesterday's match we had some brilliant fielding. Even the SRH RR match we had some terrific fielding, especially from SRH. They took some good catches,
brilliant catches,
and they anticipated, well judged. There was no. Stupid misses, if I can call it that. And fielding efforts were very good. Like yesterday happened. You had Ryan Parag actually catching a ball and dropping it back into the ground and saving 3 runs. Because they didn't... They saved 5 runs in that. You remember? Rishabh Pant said that, these guys didn't run. They thought it was going for a 6. They didn't run at all.
So that was pretty interesting. And he also had a run out.
Yes.
So that was pretty interesting.
So I think
again, this is another match. Tonight's match will be another match where we'll have two wicketkeeper captains.
Yeah, that seems like to be the order of the norm of the day these days. We'll see.
Yeah, because we have 4 teams which have wicketkeeper captains. Yeah. So 4 teams without wicketkeeper captain.
Anyway, so that is that. So I think we'll wind up today's story and we'll come back tomorrow.
Exactly. So
keep watching, keep liking, keep sharing, and stay safe behind a mask. And if you're not supposed to, if you don't have to go out, please don't. Stay at home and watch cricket.
Exactly.
Bye-bye.
Bye.